defeated, no.
I am not defeated, triumph.
The battle's already won.
This is Lamar Collins, and I want to take this time to answer several of the questions that I've been getting. Of course, we've had a couple of town halls, but I've just not had the timely or the time that I wanted to adequately answer the questions. There are three questions that I want to answer or to expound on. The first one is, why am I running for mayor? The second, what qualifies me to run for mayor? And the third, what are my top priorities as mayor? I want to take those first two questions together. Let me start by giving you a background of myself. I came here 20 years ago as a member of the United States Army. I served a combined total of 14 years in the United States Army in the Army Reserve. After I got out of the military, I went to the University of Mary Hart Baylor, where I got a degree in biology and exercise science. I taught and coached in the Killeen Independent School District for several years. Then Dr. Patricia Shulot at Scott & White asked me to come work with her in the Worth the Wait program in an effort to reduce teen pregnancy here in Bell County. I jumped at the opportunity because that was right up my alley. We were very successful, I'm glad to say so. After that, I became a director for the Scott & White healthcare system. That story is kind of interesting. The grant for Worth the Wait had actually ran its course, and I was about to go back into education. And they came to me and they said, Lamar, we want you to run a clinic. I said, guys, I've never even worked in a hospital. Why would you want me to run a clinic? They said, listen, we can teach you healthcare. What we have a problem teaching people is leadership. You are a natural leader. We want you to lead this clinic. So I led the clinic for several years. It was while I was there that I had an opportunity to go to Washington, D.C. to work with the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, and also to Austin to work with the Texas Department of Health and Human Services. While there, I got intrigued with the legislative process, so much so that I decided to go back and get my master's degree in public administration, even though my background was in education. I knew that one day I'd want to work in either city or state government. Well, I was at Scott & White as a director for several years. Then I decided to go into business for myself. My wife and I ran a couple of small businesses. And then Coach Mike Spradlin came to Temple, Texas. We started talking because my oldest daughter is a cheerleader. I went to pay her cheerleading bill. And he said, Lamar, would you like to get back into coaching? I said, Coach, I'd love to. Went back into coaching for 2 years. At the end of the second year, actually during the middle of the second year, my middle daughter, my wife and I have four children, my middle daughter is a volleyball player, and I said to myself, I have to see my daughter play volleyball. I'd been coaching, and you know, it's difficult to be a football coach and watch your daughter play volleyball. And so I said to myself, watching my daughter play volleyball is much more important than me coaching football. I resigned from coaching. Not long after that, Bill Jones resigned as mayor. My wife and I started talking, and we realized that this was the time to run for mayor. And here is why. I think Ronald Reagan said it best. Ronald Reagan said there are two types of people in this world. There are people who want to be something, and then there are people who want to do something. To be quite honest with you, it never crossed my mind to be the mayor. But it's always crossed my mind to do something about inequality. It's always crossed my mind to do something about apathy. It's always crossed my mind to do something about unemployment. And I look at being the mayor as giving me the platform to deal with those issues. If you look at my website, you'll see what I like to do for the here and now. But the forethought is what I want to share with you. The vision is what I want to share with you. I think it's important for Temple, Texas to begin looking at various modes of transportation. There are 38 million cars on I-35 every day. That number will increase by 57% by the year 2025. If we don't do something to alleviate the stress on our roads, it won't be long before Temple looks much like Dallas, Houston, and Austin with the congestion around the traffic. It's important to not just look at the I-35 expansion and think that's enough. It's not enough. We have to use rail. We have to use air. We have to consider busing. All of these transportation methods are methods that we must use to address the transportation needs in our area. Probably the most important area I'd like to address is that of workforce development. Listen, we're bringing awesome businesses into Temple. Panda's coming. Toyota's coming. We have a great distribution park or industrial park for distribution centers here in Temple. We have to make sure that we have a viable workforce. Any business that comes to Temple, they want to know, where will we get our skilled labor? It is important for the city of Temple to work with the four school districts connected to Temple. It's also important for the city of Temple to work with Central Texas College, MCC, TC, UMHB, to make sure that we're putting out educated and skilled workers. Coupled with that, right down the street at Fort Hood, there are 600 soldiers getting out of the military every month. This is a great place for those guys to relocate to work. I am the guy that can have those great discussions with business leaders. I am the guy that can continue to develop relationships with Fort Hood. I am the guy that can talk to the students at the schools and also the colleges and let them know that now is the time for you to take your success seriously. Now is the time for you to develop the God-given skills, talents, and abilities that you have that you might use them to support yourself and your family. I am the guy that sees the need to develop the I-35 corridor to bring in businesses. Here's why. When we develop that I-35 corridor and build businesses along that I-35 corridor, what we'll do is bring income into Temple that was not created in Temple. That's going to do nothing but benefit our great city. I want to be the mayor of Temple because I'm the guy that can bring more businesses in, along with the other council members, along with the Economic Development Corporation, along with the other leaders of Temple. Listen, Governor Perry has already talked about going to California and bringing businesses to Texas. Why can't they come to Temple? I'm saying they can, and if I'm elected mayor, I believe some of them will. I have a great reputation. If you'll just Google me, YouTube me, you'll see what I've been doing the last 20 years. All I've been doing is making a difference because it's not what I want to be, it's what I want to do. And being the mayor of Temple is going to give me the platform that I need to raise Temple to the next level of greatness, and not just Temple, but also the citizens of Temple. It is time for the citizens of Temple to take their rightful place. A city, just like a chain, is as only as strong as its weakest link. So the question has to be asked of the mayoral candidates, which candidate can challenge the citizens who have not been pulling their weight to pull their weight? That candidate is Lamar Collins. So when you go to early voting, I want to challenge you to vote Lamar Collins for mayor. If you wait till May 11th, I want to challenge you to vote Lamar Collins for mayor.
The battle's already won. There's a greater power. Now come on, clap your hands like this. I will not be defeated, for I know that there's victory for me. I've already won because of the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. I can see it, claim it, it's already mine. The power of life and death is in the tongue. I speak life, triumphant. I'm not defeated, no.